flatten the sugar, never stir caramel, rule number one. Now keep the pan nice and flat. I'm going to flavour this caramel with a little bit of mint. Sprinkle that into the caramel. A little teaspoon of oil onto the tray and rub that in. And then pour out the caramel with this nice minted whiffle running through my cake. Whilst the caramel cools down on the tray, I'm going to make my cake. First melt good quality dark chocolate in a bain-marie. Heating it directly in the pan will destroy the cocoa fats. Always in a bowl over boiling water. In a mixing bowl, sugar, 2 whole eggs and 3 egg yolks. Whisk until beautifully light and creamy and the colour changes to a light yellow. Next, melt some butter into your warm dark chocolate and stir. Add that to your sugar and your eggs. Now give that a really good mix. When you're making flowers, desserts, it really is important to work harder, incorporating air, especially with the yolks and the sugar. That natural height needs to take place at the beginning. Then separate 4 egg whites into a bowl. Now, make sure you've got 2/3 of the way there with your whites, and then just sprinkle in your sugar. Almost like a meringue. That's what we call a stiff peak. In with the whites. Before I start mixing that, I'm in the caramel. Just start breaking that up. Glass, sheets of glass, beautiful. Save some of your minty caramel shards for decoration and use a rolling pin to break up the rest into small pieces. Sprinkle that in. As we start to slice that chocolate cake, you'll come across that nice crunch. Take your cake tin, make sure it's lined. Pour this in. A few sharp taps on a hard surface will rid your cake mixture of any air pockets that could create holes in your cake. Sit that in the oven, 180. After 35 minutes, my chocolate mint cake is cooked, and whilst it cools down, I can whip up a peppermint cream topping. Add sifted icing sugar and a few drops of peppermint extract to double cream, and whisk until it's just holding its shape. Sprinkle minty cream on top of the cake, leaving a small border free to make it easier to cut. For a cake that can't fail to attract attention at your party, scatter over the remaining caramel mint shards. Now, to unveil my incredible beetroot cured salmon. Off with the weight. A tray. And look what's happened to the salmon. Absolutely beautiful. You can just tell how delicious that's going to be with this sort of sheen. Give that a little rinse in cold water. Traditionally, cured salmon would be sliced into large, thin pieces like smoked salmon, but I like to cut mine into thin strips. It's easier and it will show off its beauty. Really busy colours. Nice dark red to move red. Now, when you've got cured salmon, it's good. Trust me, you just need a salad, double toast, or some stunning bread. That's the secret for me to any good party. Couple masterpieces. Simple, straightforward ingredients, but done properly.
how we live it. Don't be mad at the system, it's simply how we've existed. I hear a lot of people talking like they politicians and choose to be.